I am Darren Thornton. I'm the director of A Date for Mad Mary. It is about a young girl who gets out of prison, started a story for assaulting another girl. She comes back home to her small town called Drogheda, and she's inveigled into the wedding plans for her best friend, who used to be a hellraiser like she was, but she's now sort of moved on and grown up. And it's kind of about the disintegration of that friendship, and it's also about the wedding and Mary trying to find a date to bring to the wedding so that she can prove to her old friend that she's capable in some ways of growing up in the same way that her friend Charlene has. It was originally a play by Yasmin Akram, and I directed the play with Yasmin Akram, and I'd toured it for a year with her. And just because I'd spent so much time with the character and I'd really become really fond of her, and I wanted to spend more time with her, and I wanted to develop the story and take it in another direction. And at the same time, Yazzie's career was as an actor was taking off over here, so she let myself and my brother Colin work on an adaptation of it. So yeah, it was just really to kind of further, and also the play was quite different, as the play was really very much about the dating aspect of the story, and with the film we wanted to explore friendship, we wanted to explore the idea of what it's like for a young girl to be losing her best friend. How does she find her way on her own and stuff like that? That was really what we were interested in getting into. Adapting this one was relatively straightforward because it was a monologue. So it was structured in some ways very much like a film already anyway. So it made it a lot easier. I suppose, you know, it's a film is a visual medium, and theatre is about the spoken word. So you're trying to find ways, different ways to tell the story. You're trying to find ways in which you can show things, and so that I wouldn't say it's challenging. It's enjoyable actually. And then I suppose with this particular kind of story, we wanted to do something that was really raw and really visceral. So you're trying to find a way in which you can draw the audience really, really close to the character. And in a way that's not necessarily about her speaking or interacting. It's just about letting, you know, creating a space in which the audience can just hang out with her and observe her and share in her boredom and sort of, you know, kind of watch behavior and stuff like that. So that's interesting because the play was a very different sort of, you know, energetic piece, where Yasmin as Mary would have been doing a lot of multiple. She was creating all the characters physically, and then when we wanted to do something that was that had a stillness to it, that was really about just allowing the camera just to sit and watch what was happening for her and watch her trying to process how her life is unraveling and stuff like that. So, you know, it was interesting. We got a great leading performance by Shauna Kerslake, who's an incredible actor, and we saw a great time working with her, and kind of loved finding her at the beginning of it, and in many ways we built the film around what she was doing. You know, when she came in to play Mary, we had various ideas on how we were going to make the film, and then when she came in, there was something that was so honest about what she was doing that we started to pair things back. We got a fantastic supporting performance from Charlie Bailey, who's equally brilliant, and Tara Lee, who's exceptional as well, really great, and a fantastic musician as well in her own right. And it was fun for us to be able to bring Tara into perform, because the character sang in the movie and stuff like that. It was great to be able to use that skill set with Tara. And then we have Denise McCormick, who's a veteran TV actor in Ireland, who's incredible in it. And just, she plays Mary's mom, and she's in some ways the sort of beating heart of the film as well. And so it was great just to be able to kind of put that world, and they're all very, very different from each other, and yet together they're beautiful. Like, they're really, really great. I think I'm really proud of what we got from them. So yeah. The start of it, me and Colin would have talked about, we wanted to create something that sort of lived somewhere between, you know, these like John Hughes films that we grew up loving, these sort of 80s coming of age dramas, and then these other like Ken Loach movies, these really raw, visceral stories that he's, so how can you make a film that sort of lives somewhere in the middle that has elements of both of those very different kinds of cinema. So that was kind of where we started from. That was always, it was difficult, but it was fun to try and sort of nail that kind of tone that was, deadpan and funny, but that was also really visceral and really raw and really violent at times, and being able to sort of transition between both. So it was a challenge in the, it was a challenge when we were writing the script. It was also a challenge when we were filming it, and it was a really big challenge when we were editing it, trying to just maintain that one consistent tone right the way through, where you could alternate between, comedy and then very, very dark drama. But I think a lot of it is then to Shauna's performance and being able to sort of, navigate that, and, then just being smart enough, I suppose, on our part to be able to sort of allow for that and not get in the way too much, really. Yeah, we had a beautiful screening last night in the Picture House in Soho, which is it's an incredibly big screen, so it was like seeing it in IMAX or something. We were sort of like, wow, this is, that's what it looks like. I was seeing things that I'd never seen before in the film. So it's beautiful. It's great. It's a great place, and we've been. The only thing is that we're like trying to see so many. There's so many movies on that we want to see as just film fans as well. So we're trying to do meetings and cut them really short because we're want to run down the road to see some movie that's shown in a cinema nearby and stuff. But it's great. It's a nice mixture of having great chats with other filmmakers and meeting people that are interested in your work, and then getting to see really cool films as well. So it's good. Yeah, it's great.